Hey everyone, this video is part of our Blockchain in 30 Days challenge. In this video, we are going to talk about operators in Solidity and see through examples of how they can be used in your code. To not overcomplicate things, we are going to group operators based on their type and talk about all the operators of the same type together. Let's get into the video. In Solidity, like many other programming languages, we have five operator types, namely arithmetic, comparison, logical, assignment, and conditional. Starting with arithmetic, we have addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, modulus, increment, and decrement. As the name suggests, all of them perform some sort of mathematical operation on the operands involved, but it is not always that simple. Let's talk about uint. As you may know, different versions of uint have different sizes like uint 8, uint 16 and so on, as well as unsigned int can't go below 0. So what happens if we force it to? In the versions greater than 0.8.0, which is the primary focus of this series, you will get an error and your transaction would be reverted, wasting all gas fees used up till that point. Therefore, with all the arithmetic operations, you need to keep in mind the minimum and maximum expected values as well as how you handle the error. Next, we have comparison operators, which include equality, non-equality, greater than, less than, greater than equal to, and less than equal to. These take two operands and return a boolean. The question now is what you can compare in Solidity. Not all data types are compatible for comparison. For example, trying to compare a uint with an address gives an error, but comparing a uint 256 with uint 8 still works. But comparison of uint and int does not work and gives an error. Keeping this in mind, whenever you are writing contract, make sure the data types are actually comparable. Next, we have logical operators, namely AND, OR, and NOT. These operators work with Boolean operands and return a bool. These are especially useful in cases when you want to combine two or more comparison operators for a condition. Then we have bitwise operators, which you may already be familiar with. Bitwise operations may not be as common in usage, but can help you on algorithmic side. We won't discuss it much as part of this video, but there is a really good Medium article on this topic that we recommend you to check out. Next, we have assignment operators. The equal operator assigns the right-hand side value to the left-hand side operators, and all other operators in this category first perform an operation and then assign the value. For example, let's take the statement a plus equals 5. This translates to a equals a plus 5, and it is the same for all other operators in this category. Finally, we have the ternary operator, which decides a value based on a conditional statement. Its syntax is this. This is useful one-line solution when you need to assign the value of a variable based on a condition. Now we have covered a decent chunk of operators in this video, but there is additional reading that you can do. We have dropped a link to documentation for the same in the description, so you can go ahead and check that out. That's it for this video, but there's more for you to watch. Check out the blockchain playlist to find more videos like this or this video that YouTube recommends for you, and we'll see you next time.